Hey, Shad here with Speed Addicts, the fastest growing gear site on the web, and today we're going to uncrate the Z1R Solaris. Before we jump in and give you one of the best helmet reviews you've ever seen in your life, go ahead and subscribe. That helps us keep bringing you that awesome gear content here at speedaddicts.com. Okay, Z1R Solaris, number one modular helmet at speedaddicts.com by volume. We sell tons and tons of these. Why? Well, high quality, perfect price point. They've kept it at $149 for most sizes, those big head sizes. You know, I think it's 3X or 2X and up is a few dollars more, but still awesome price point, great quality. So that price, extra small all the way up through 4X, that's another reason. So they do have helmets for you larger heads out there. Well, not a lot of other brands do. This helmet is intermediate oval, fits true to size. It is a polycarbonate shell, and it is comm system ready. So you're getting all the goodies, well under $200. We'll show you those speaker pockets. When I say comm system ready, that's what I mean. So as far as the fit, go buy that Z1R sizing chart at speedaddicts.com. And remember, we make shopping for gear online as easy as possible at SpeedAddicts. Not only are we gonna pay to get the helmet to you, but if it doesn't fit, decide you don't like it, as long as it's new in the original packaging, we'll actually pay to bring it back. So that's why you should buy your next helmet from SpeedAddicts. Okay, enough shameless plugs. Let's talk more about this Solaris. So first thing you're gonna notice, modern design. You see the angles, you see the sweeps, you see that arrow work. This is not something you usually get on what we would call a price point helmet. So very sexy design, nice big ventilation switches. But before I talk about that, I wanted to talk about this paint. So this is the wine red. This is the number one selling color we have. It's got a little bit of a metallic to it. It's really deep, good looking paint. I mean, it's shocking what they're producing for this price point. And I'm not just saying that so you buy this thing. It is really in person. The pictures really don't do it justice. So the paint quality, top notch. Another thing Z1R is doing right is they're not slapping their logo on this thing. Yes, Z1R is a name that's been in the business for a long time, but not everybody wants a big ugly logo. These guys have been around since the 90s. The company behind them has been around for decades in the business. They're one of the biggest distributors out there. So it's not a fly-by-night operation. They're gonna stand behind the product. In case you do have any issues, they're not going anywhere. And before we jumped on camera here, I talked to the team, and because I don't remember the last time we've heard of a warranty issue with a Z1R, and no one can come up with an example. So they do have a one-year warranty on this guy in case you should run into problems, but it's probably not something that's gonna happen from our experience. Okay, let's talk about the ventilation. So nice big ram air vent up here on the forehead, and it's two-tone, right? It's black, so it kind of looks cool, matches the bottom ventilation. Easy peasy to work with gloves. Big sliding vent, easy to find. Same down below, super simple, no drama, easy to find. Ventilation in the back, so you have your exhaust ports. Intake is no good without exhaust. This combination gives you that vacuum ventilation that sucks the hot air out and pulls the cool air in and keeps you nice and chilly when it's hot out. Also inside of here, the EPS foam that absorbs energy in case of an impact is ported in channel. We'll show you more of that in a minute. But this is a modular helmet, right? I kind of buried the lead here. So when it comes to modular helmets at this price point, usually they do not inspire confidence when you open the chin bar, when you work the parts. You also have that drop down sun visor, right? So all quality stuff here. It feels solid when you move it. And if you're not getting enough ventilation from that ventilation system I just showed you, you can always pop this up. That's kind of the point, right? Modular helmets are great to talk to a passenger. You're going through town, you want a little more, bit more air. Most of them are not meant to be ridden in this upright position unless you're really kind of cruising low speeds. Remember, the number one place for impact in a motorcycle accident, of course, is this area here. So for max safety, you're gonna wanna keep that locked down in the full face riding position. While we're talking about safety, this helmet is DOT and ECE 2205 rated. DOT, of course, is the US standard for a street legal helmet. ECE is the European standard. These tests and homologations prioritize different parts of helmet safety. So when I see a helmet that is dual labeled, both ECE and DOT, I know they're doing their best to cover all their bases, so that is a nice thing. Best of both worlds, hopefully. Okay, how we work that sun visor right here, super easy. Left side, right side, throttle side. So they always put that on the left. Drop down so you got that sun protection. The visor changes are really quick and painless. They got a little trigger here that disengages that. And they make a smoke and iridium, so if you want to mix it up and do a little bit more sun protection on the outside, you don't want to rely on that interior visor, you can mix and match the outside. If you're not going to use that interior sun visor, you can just pull it out of place and not run it. It's one less thing to move around and it's less weight, right? So if you don't want to use that, you don't have to. Let's flip this guy over and show you what we're working with inside. While I'm doing that, I'm going to tell you that this helmet is also made in a snow configuration with either a dual pane lens or an electric lens. They also sell those separately. So if you're in a place where snow happens, you can buy the standard version and then piece together the breath box or the dual pane or electric visor should you want to take this out on your sled. You can do so, or you can just buy the snow version from the beginning. Okay, underneath, double D-ring closure, straightforward here. They do have that little strap snap, so it keeps the end from blowing around in the breeze. Inside, moisture wicking. It's kind of like a polyester or kind of a neoprene feel to it. It's nice, it's gonna keep you cool when it's hot and warm when it's cool. These do come out, so this is fully removable, washable liner system. Real easy. Wash that in the sink, let it air dry. If you beat them down, you can replace them. Remember, helmets are meant to break in a little bit. This one has plenty of low-density squishy foam, so I usually remind people, buy the helmet, test fit it in your living room, make sure it fits nice and snug, and allow for a little bit of break-in, usually about 10% once this stuff packs in, right? Okay, other thing you're gonna notice is this this chin curtain that's gonna keep the elements out, hopefully keep some noise and wind out of your helmet. Let's flip this up. We'll show you those speaker pockets. What comm system should you run? Whichever one you want. You got nice deep speaker pockets, you can plug those in. On a modular helmet like this, you do have some interference with certain angles. You're probably gonna wanna go with an adhesive mount on this particular helmet because of that, because getting a clip mount down here on the shell is tricky when you have this slide in the way. But adhesive mount's the way to go. I'm gonna flip up this headliner so that you can see how this looks in here. Channeled and ported, so that air that's rushing through between the EPS and the shell is actually getting onto your scalp and keeping it cool. Z1R, Solaris, yeah, it's really hard to beat it. No one has really been able to produce a modular helmet in this price range that is this high of quality, and our sales numbers go to show. If you look at this thing, it's got tons of reviews at Speed Addicts, and they're overwhelmingly positive as I cut off the chin strap there. So, you want one of these, head over to speedaddicts.com if you're not already there. Get over there and pick up a Z1R Solaris. You won't be sorry. We appreciate you guys watching. Don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you next time to find out what's in the crate.